raised during the past few moments. Now, let me say, looking at the details of line items in our budget these days, I think it's high time we stop being excited or unexcited about any increase or decrease in budget allocation. Because it does not mean anything for the ordinary person on the street. Whether the budget increased by 1 million or 10 million or whatever, it does not mean anything. When you go to the details of the line items, you see that they have completely no relationship with improvements in the life side or in the welfare of people. So this idea of 15%, 20%, for me, does not count for Nigeria. Until our budget starts to have better integrity, the idea of any increases or decreases or meeting any international deadlines does not count. Because when you look at the details of the budget, it does not matter. It has no link with improving the lives of people. You see things like M&E for procurement. What kind of line item is that? And in such line items, you might get as much as 100 million. When you accumulate 100 million in 10 places, it gives you 1 billion. And when you see a ministry whose budget has been increased by 1 or 2 billion, you feel there's some kind of improvement. If you look at the detail, it does not mean anything. It does not translate to anything better for the people. Let me react on the issue of education now. If you are doing analysis of the federal budget at this level, we need to understand some fundamental facts. Mandate for education does not solely lie with the federal government. As far as possible, at the level of the ministry headquarters, what the ministry is supposed to do is purely policy advice, direction, coordination, and all those policy-related high-level things. In terms of primary education, in terms of secondary education, which is the bulk of the entire expenditure for education in any society, the responsibility lies with the local government and state government. So when you are doing this kind of analysis, it's very difficult to do a complete and comprehensive link of the education status in this country to federal budgets. Because the federal government has responsibility for a very minute aspect of our education system. Basically, higher education and high-level research and technology. That's number one. Secondly, on the area of youth, the Ministry of Youth Development or whatever agencies that it has under it completely have no strong link or relationship with youth development. Youth development can be expressed in education, can be expressed in health, can be expressed in employment, can be expressed in public investment, in public utilities, and every other thing that has to do with youth development. So the fact that their budget increases or decreases completely has no link with the youth on the street, because they don't have mandate holistically for youth development. They could provide policy advice, they could provide coordination, like having interministerial committees to coordinate activities that affect youth in various ministries, but they do not have mandate generally for youth development of any sort, because they don't have what it takes, as far as I'm concerned, based on design and capacity for youth development. Thank you.